Yes, my people, you're welcome back to Victor Isibo Reviews channel. Thank you for coming back to this channel. I admire your loyalty. I appreciate your dedication. And for the newcomers, I believe that at the end of this video, you will find a reason to what? Hit the red subscribe button, turn on the bell notification so that you will be a part of this wonderful, wonderful family. Some time ago, I did a video about transportation business in Nigeria, how lucrative it is, and the step-by-step procedures you need to follow so that you don't make mistakes. You'll find that video somewhere here. Okay, so you can just click on it and, you know, watch the video so that you can understand why and how we got to this topic that we're treating today. So today we're going to be talking about the type of vehicles you must not buy and use for your transportation business. Without further ado, let's jump right into the video. There are three categories of vehicles that you are going to find in the marketplace, in the vehicle marketplace. Every typical car stand have three categories of vehicles. Category number one, they are the brand new vehicles. Category number two, they are the foreign used vehicles. Nigerians call it Tokumbo. Some people call it direct Belgium. Category number three are locally used vehicles. Some people call it numbered vehicles. Some people call it Nigerian used vehicles. Now, let's talk briefly about number one. Category number one, brand new vehicle. You have little or no problem as per inspection of a brand new vehicle. The vehicles are always in top shape, very good shape. The mileage is about zero. Nobody has used the car except for test runs, which should be a little bit above zero. The car is fine, maintenance wise, everything. But what you need to look out for is to make sure that you are buying from registered sales distributors of the vehicle's company. Why? So that they'll be able to give you some years of warranty, free maintenance within a particular period of time and stuff like that. And when you buy a brand new vehicle, make sure you don't give it to any roadside mechanic if need be for servicing or whatever. Make sure you take it to the designated showroom of the brand of the vehicle that you bought. Okay, look out for the designated maintenance and servicing centers of that brand new vehicle that you bought. You don't want to give it to a roadside mechanic that will spoil your vehicle. Category number two, the foreign used vehicle, or the so-called Tokumbo or direct Belgium. You are a little bit safe if you buy this kind of vehicle for your transportation business, because these vehicles are vehicles that have been used in Europe or other advanced countries where they have good road network, and it has been used by people who have good maintenance culture of their vehicle. So these cars are not so different from brand new cars. They look very good. What you need to look out for, you look at the mileage so that you will be certain that the car has not been overused. So the mileage is going to guide you as per how you are going to price the vehicle and, you know, the pricing and stuff like that. But you can still ensure that you go with a skilled mechanic, a skilled and a trusted mechanic, so that that engineer, that automobile engineer, will be able to assess the car and tell you, this is what you need to fix, that's what you need to fix. You don't really need to fix much if the direct Belgium or Tokumbo or foreign used vehicle has not taken too much abuse. Most times you don't have a problem. But you can't be too careful. Go with the mechanic and let them check it very well before you can buy it. The third category, the Nigerian used vehicle. This is the category that I do not recommend that you buy for your transportation business. A business takes time for you to start making profit, and you don't want distractions along the way. If you are using a problematic vehicle for your transportation business, when you make 2,000, you spend 5,000 on it. When you make 5,000, you spend 10,000 on it. So that kind of car is a car I do not recommend at all. Why don't I recommend Nigerian used vehicles that are being put up for sale at the car shops? This is it. I'm a Nigerian. A typical Nigerian that has used a car very well and the car is still sound and he wants to sell it, he will sell it to his siblings. If none of his siblings are up to buy the car, they will sell it to their neighbors, church members, colleagues, anybody that is close to them, because they see it as they are doing that person a favor. So they will look for somebody around them to sell the car to. But for a typical Nigerian to now take that car to a car shop, sell this car for me, and he himself that took the car there is trekking around, is taking public transport, for somebody to dump his only car at a car shop, putting it up for sale, and is trekking around, don't you know that there's a problem somewhere? That car must have been draining the life out of the owner. You know those kind of cars that you and your wife put as prayer points? I once bought a Nigerian used vehicle at a car shop. So when it was time to do the paperwork, the owner was invited, and we now did the paperwork. As we were doing the paperwork, after I had made payment, his wife called him. He now broke the news to his wife, saying, I finally sold the car, and I'm just issuing the receipt to the man. His wife was like, praise the Lord, Jesus, hallelujah, I'm so happy. I could hear from the background as she was shouting and praising God. After the call, I said, Oga, he said, Oga, he said, how many times did I call you? He said, twice. I said, who did you just finish speaking with? He said, it was his wife. I said, why was your wife praising God that you have sold this car to me? He was like, I don't take it to heart. She was just happy because I need the money to travel out. They will always tell you that. I need the money to travel out. I need the money for one project or the other, because they will not want to tell you the real problem that that car had. I bought the car. That car, a Nissan Xterra SUV. That car, I would buy fuel in the morning, fill up the tank, then I would park it in my house. I didn't go anywhere. By the time I start the car in the evening that I want to go out, the fuel will be telling me that it is too low. Fuel low, refuel now. Why will I refuel? I just filled this tank in the morning. Where did all the fuel go? I don't know. Maybe I will ask Google. That car gave me problems. Problems that anytime I'm praying, I'll pray for my family, pray for my career, pray that God should bring a buyer for this car. I dropped the car. I started taking public transport everywhere. Finally, God sent me a victim. God sent me a buyer to come and buy the car. If you see the way I was shaking when I was preparing the paperwork for him to carry the car, eventually, when the guy sent money to me, I sold it at a very ridiculously cheap price. When he sent the money, I didn't get a lot on time. Over excitement, I left everything for him, let him go, because I was eager and anxious to do away with the car. A Nigerian used vehicle will make a mechanic your best friend. When people have the numbers of their mechanic on their phone, they are always calling mechanic every time, because you will always be visiting the mechanic's workshop. When I was using that Nigerian used vehicle, I was visiting my mechanic almost every week. There was a particular time I traveled. I left the car in the house. I traveled without the car. I stayed 3 weeks away. In the third week, while I was still away, my mechanic called me. He was like, hello, sir. Are you okay? I said, I'm okay. He said, long time. I hope there's no problem. I said, there's a problem. He said, what problem, sir? I said, I'm not around. That is the problem. Because had it been I was around, I would have come to you to spend money on my car as usual. So you don't want that kind of car for your business, okay? So if you don't have enough money to buy a brand new vehicle, you should aim to buy a foreign used vehicle or a Tokumbo. It is better for your business, okay? I hope you learned something new from this video, okay? If you found value from this video, give me a like. Give me a like, it's free for you to like the video. It won't cost you any amount, I swear it won't. Like the video, you will see that it won't cost you anything. So if you have liked it now, how much did you pay? Free of charge. Then if you're a first timer here and you love tips like this, you want to enhance your business, you want to enhance your spirituality, you want to enhance your day-to-day relationship and interactions with people, hit the subscribe button. It's also free, yes, just as free as liking the video. Okay, till I see you next time, I remain Victor Esibo. It's bye for now.